my lovely people, so welcome back to my channel Greeta Rose. So if you like my content, please support my channel by subscribing. If you have already supported me, thank you for supporting me. So today I am here with an unboxing type of video. So I got this new deck, the Shaman's Dream Oracle. I pre-ordered it. So yeah, this was the first deck that I pre-ordered. I don't know, I was very into it. When I just saw on the Amazon, I was just scrolling through Amazon, I just saw this deck and I was like intuitively very drawn to that deck. So that's the reason I pre-ordered. So yeah, so these are the authors of the deck. And then this is illustrated by Gina. Okay, so this is a deck, 64 card deck. Okay, so the box look good, right? So let's unbox. So I'll do the flip through of the cards. Okay, so it's like this here and it's written, we are sacred dreamers dreaming the world into being. And then there is a guidebook, of course, we need that. So yeah, it's good. I read this guidebook, it's good. It's detailed, so I like it. And so we have so the introduction is there, then you know this, it's all about symbolism because it's about dreams, so a lot of symbols are there in the cards and I like that. The illustration is very good. Then yeah, of course, how to work with this deck, you know, that kind of thing. And then of course the meanings of the cards, interesting. This deck is interesting, I like it. So yeah, so let me flip through and you know, the I like the way the cards are, you know, the box, I like the box, you know, you know, you can take it like this, so I just like it. And this is my first deck you know, that has this kind of a box, so I like it. Okay, so let's start. Okay, so I'm just gonna flip through all the cards. So I'm just gonna keep these here aside. So let's see. So it's a 64 deck cards. Okay, so let's start. Okay, so I'm just gonna flip through. I'll just show you. This is a tidy house, clarity and organization. At the end of the video, I'll be just doing a small pick a card. So stay tuned for that. Okay, so just I'm gonna show it. It's just a flip through. So beautiful. This card is very nice. I like it. The illustration is good. But the cards are not so, you know, it's like a little bit the quality I didn't like that much. But yeah. The cards are good. This is nice, right? I like it. Caterpillar, it's a cat and a caterpillar. Nice, I like that. Okay, closing door, completion. This card is like, I felt like it is not so clear when I was seeing. I don't know, but maybe that is the way. The colors are light, so I was like, let's see next one. Sacred contract, crown games. That's a nice deck. Oh, sorry, nice. Nice. I like the art, you know, lot of symbols in each card. We can just, you know, intuitively, we can pick a lot, I feel like. Yeah, we don't need the meaning. We can just intuitively connect with it. And the colors, everything, you know. So a lot of symbols are there. Look, the jellyfish. Deep, quiet. Look at the colors. They're so beautiful. Shiny, shiny. Dragons, hot. Look at that eyes, oh god, that's so, okay, it's like threatening us or something like that. Okay, instructor. Empty well, nothing there. It's like there is no water, don't, no use of going there, doing this thing, nothing is there, some kind, it felt like that. There is nothing there, it's empty. You will not get the water there. Yeah, eye of the needle, yeah. Look at that, it's good, it's beautiful. Wow, this I like this card very much. I don't know why, but I just felt very drawn to this card with the eagle. Falling angel. Some cards are like a little bit light. I just felt like that. I don't know why, but maybe yeah, they could have just add, for me, I felt it should be more colorful or something. Maybe they just want it like that, but I felt like it should be more, you sometimes we have to look into it because I'm not able to see the symbols in this, in it because it feels very light. It's just my opinion anyways. So, Feast of Plenty. If you will watch my pick a card, this card is there, the April predictions. So, Fool's Embrace. Fortune's Wheel, luck and right timing. Good card to get, right? The Divine Metrics. Mushroom. Wow, this card is so beautiful. The colors, look at the colors, they're so beautiful. And the hummingbird there. Is it a crystal? I like this card. Gathering around. Heart home. Hollow bone. This is like kind of an ancestor card. I felt like your ancestors are with you or something like that. I'm feeling like an ancestor vibe with this card. Wow, that's beautiful. With the cactus. Horseman. In the hand. Wow, the universe is your partner. This is nice. Connectivity. Oh wow, this is lovely, right? I like this. The cat, look at the expression of the cat and the number 33. Wow, I just like that. The cat is so happy. The cat is like so excited. Lay of the land. Okay, did I show you this? Okay. Lost compass, getting back to integrity. Lost in space. Magician sword. Many mask. Detox, repairing the body, mind, spirit. That's a mermaid. She's chilling in the bathtub. Interesting. It's like self-care, mindful. New beginnings. Netcaster. Overflow, wow, look at that. Oh, perfect storm. 44. Preparing the veil. Rude girl, the disowned self. Oh God, this is nice. Our inner child. I feel like the inner child. Sometimes our inner child needs healing, right? Sometimes we take our past. That is what I feel like. Sometimes we don't nurture our inner child. It's like sometimes we disown that little girl or little boy. And yeah. I'm sorry for that. Sky bridge. Possibility for union. A lot of symbols. Sky dancer, surrender. Sky writing, the fates. Oh, it's the runes, I guess. Yeah. There is a blue feather. Spirit of the river. Stars in the sky, limitless possibility. Look at that person doing meditation. Look at the stars. So beautiful. This is a beautiful card. Stranger. The crossing. The wall obstacles. Vanishing mirror. Watchers. Neil song. Good vibes. Wives, sorry. So this is the deck, 64 card deck. Okay, so yeah, I'll just do a pick a card, small pick a card. Okay, so I have already shuffled the cards. So this is for group number one, amethyst. For group number two, I have selenite. For group number three, this is aventurine. So let's see what you need to know right now. So that is going to be the message. So what you need to know right now. So the for amethyst people, if you chose the amethyst, then this is the card. Okay, we have magician sword, confidence in your magic. So with this sword, you know, I'm getting the magician energy. Okay, so it's time to manifest your dreams, desire. It's time to go get that. Don't listen to other people or cut the people who are not being helpful. So let's just read this. When the magician's sword appears, you are called to cut the cords that bind you to old thought forms and beliefs, or to friends who are not true. With the power of magician's sword, nothing can stop you, hurt you, or turn you away from the beauty you seek or the goal you desire with all your heart. Yes. Okay, so that is what I feel like. Yeah, it's time to cut the limited beliefs that you have and go and do it. Okay. When the magician's sword appears, it is time to get moving. It is not a tool for contemplation, for gazing at the finely polished edge. It is an instrument calling for decisive action. And remember, the sword is alive with the wisdom you can summon to help you find the best course of action. Do not hesitate. Act. So it's time to act. You know, it's not the time to evaluate and sit. Maybe you have an opportunity. You have been provided with the opportunity and you are like thinking whether I should take, and you're asking advice of other people, and there are people around you who are not so giving you good advice. So with this card, you need to take the action, what your heart says. If it's saying just go for it, just go for it. Don't listen to other people. It's time. You have the resources. Make it, you know, you can make anything happen with this magician energy of our tarot cards. Yeah, magician makes everything happen because he has all the resources, and this is what the card is saying. You have every resources, okay? And yeah, number 10, 10 to 1. So yeah, that's like beginning, something beginning. So just go and take action. Go act. So selenite, if you chose selenite, let's see what is for you guys. Hollow bone, teachability. Okay, so for some of you, it's time to teach to other people, to young people. Maybe you have some wisdom inside of you that you need to convey to others. And I'm getting this ancestor vibe for this card. Let's see anyways. The hollow wing bone of an eagle is a flute for the shamans. Okay, shamans. Yeah, ancestor. That is where I got the ancestor vibe with this card. You know, shamans. The appearance of the hollow bone invites you to become empty of your notions of who you are, to check your ego at the door, and to know that it is not about you. Relinquish your need to be right and to express an opinion, as this will not change anything right now. You have been called to practice humility. But with this, you know, I'm feeling like for some of you, you have a lot of wisdom, and you are very much are you like these kind of people who are like very much afraid what other people will think if you put something on social media, or if you put a blog, if you start doing something, you are like very afraid of that. So I feel like it's time to let go of that. I'm getting the message, okay, intuitively. So it's time to let go of that. Do what you like, okay, because you have that wisdom. You can give that, you know, you can give a lot of wisdom to other people. So don't stop yourself. Interestingly, we got 9-10 in this card, also 10 number, it turns up too. Okay, hollow yourself out and hear the wind blow through you and play you like a flute. You will learn the language of the squall and the storm and understand the message in the summer breeze. There is an important communication waiting for you. Oh, humility is the swiftest, I'm sorry. path for you to become like hollow bone. Drop all notions and titles and bolster your ego. Eliminate the dual and allow things to happen of their own accord. Remember that you can accomplish most anything if you are willing to let someone else take credit for it. Okay so it's time to practice humility. It's time to, okay, so that is also coming here. So let's see a hollow bone has come to caution you to believe only 50% of, yeah, okay, this is making sense. Believe only 50% of what others think and only 10% of what you think. Trust your experience, not what you have read in sacred books or holy texts. This will allow you to turn apparent danger into opportunity. Remember that you are an insignificant grain of sand in the grand scheme of life and as important as the brightest sun. So with this, really, I feel like it's time to get inside, connect with your, you know, yourself, and look, it's not about what you think, it's about your inner self, it's about your intuition, something like that. So that's it for the group number 3. If you chose aventurine, stars in the sky is limitless possibility, guys. Lot of possibilities, lot of opportunities for you guys are coming, okay? So, and just take that opportunity. Okay, let's read this also. Limitless possibility. Sorry if I read something. Excuse my pronunciation, okay? Like if I read something wrong, forgive me. Embracing opportunity. So when you look up into the velvety dark blanket of the night sky covering the vast expanse of space, can you count all the stars twinkling above? Can you imagine that you are only glimpsing a teeny sliver of what is actually there? This is the domain of limitless possibility, of the never-ending sea of potential that you yourself are made of and have now at your disposal. Your life right now is alive with possibility and needs your clear focus to home in on what avenue of exploration most calls to you. It's time to choose and not to be distracted by the sheer magnitude of what may be. Be here now, of course, with the meditation, we can understand that it's time to be in the present moment. Gather your thoughts and your most cherished dreams. Focus on the brightest star in your never-ending sky and take small steps, small movements towards calling in the towards calling this glittering potential into reality. If you can imagine this and hold that vision, you will summon all the celestial helpers and guides to aid you in bringing it into fruition. Keep your focus on the essence of potential rather than the form of it. The universe has its own ideas of how best to serve you and all of us at the same time. Trust this as a fact rather than theory, and you ought not act surprised when your dreams come true, for they surely will exactly how you need them to. So yes, the universe is with you. They are guiding you, group number three. Okay, so whoever chose the seventh shrine, you're meant to be successful. So just be in the present moment, enjoy life, and there is so much more to it. Okay, yeah, so much more that you don't know it, you know, there's so much more to it, and of course your dreams will be a reality. Okay, so yeah, that's it for this unboxing video. Hope you liked it. Take care, guys. Bye-bye.